Here you see that plus plus I or I plus plus. Now pay attention. It is really important to understand what it means. Now, remember that plus plus I means that increment the value of X or I, whatever the variable, by one. Increment the X value by one. Similarly, X plus plus means also increment the X by one, but the timing is different. So pay attention, timing, when, timing is different. Okay, pay attention, when, the question is that. If it is plus plus X, we call it prefix. If it is X plus plus, we call it postfix, according to the location of plus plus increment by one operator. If it is in the prefix, if it comes before the variable, it means that you have to increment the X value and use this value in the statement, in the expression, in the calculation. But if it is X plus plus, it means that use the X value, current value X, in the expression, in the calculation. After calculation is done, then increment the X value by one. Do you understand the difference between timing?
Yes.
Okay, I move on. It's the same for the minus minus X or X minus one. The timing is different.
Teacher, can you give an example?
Okay, let's give an example here. Here we have the variable declaration with initialization. So I have to put num. When solving a problem, do it like I do. Okay. Num is 10. Here I am. Let me put the output screen. In the exams and in the homeworks, we will provide a box like that. And you have to write your last answer to that box. If you write your answer here, will not grade. We will not grade it. If you write your answer here, we will not grade here. Only write the answer here, not do not try to sketch it. But final exam, final result must be here. Okay? You can try here, you can try here, but you cannot try here. This must be the correct last version of your result. We will only read this one in a box. In the exam, we will provide a box for you. Okay. And this kind of questions like that in the exams and the homeworks, it's gonna like trace the code. Trace the code. What is the output? And write the output provided box. That's the question. So output means that we, as I will do always, you will go line by line, apply all the rules we have learned to that code and print the results as in the here, exactly the same. You cannot put more or less. Okay, I will do again everything for you. Let me clear the screen. So in the exams, and you know that you are gonna have one homework, right? So in the homework, you have only a limited time, only 1 hour. So you will download the homework from the Moodle and upload to the Moodle, not email, right? So please be online. You have only 1 hour. If 1 hour is finished, I mean, it is 22. Is it finished like that? It's, I think, 22, I believe. You cannot submit 22:05 because system automatically closes itself, shut down itself. You cannot do it and you will get zero. So please, start your exam and finish your exam on the homework correctly. It's really important. Do not cry out later. All right. Now let's do the first one. Printf placeholder and backslash and num. Now the current value num is 10. I will put 10 because I know that I have to come back to a new line. Now I know that I am waiting here. After that, now I have plus plus num. What should I do if it is prefix? First, increment the value and then use it. You can repeat by yourself. Increment the value, then use it. So let's increment the value and use it. And then come to the next line. Now it is here. How should I read it? I should read it like that. Use the num current value, use it, then increment it. Now let's use it, 11, then increment it, it is 12. Is it clear now, Eylül?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, let's continue. Here we have the printf num. So what is the value of num? 12. Put the 12 here. Now we have the num minus minus. How should I read it? Use the num value, then decrement it. Let's use the num value. What is the num value? 12. Use in the printf statement. And then, after the printf statement, then decrement it. Now it's 11. In that statement, however, decrement the num value, then use it in the printf. Decrement first. And then use in the printf. 10. Here, printf the current value. 10. Umur, is it okay for you, Umur? Any questions? Should I, can I continue or more? Here we have another example. I will do one of them. The other you can do by yourself. All right. So how can we solve such a question? As I do always, please do like that. If it's in the exam, assume that in the exam the question is that. Trace the code. Trace the code. Write the output to the box. Let me put the box here. Okay. How can I solve this? I put the variable names here and the current values beneath. So C is 9, D is 3. What is the value for A and B? What is the value for A and B? A and B values?
9.
A and B values. A and B values. Garbage. We talk about 3 weeks, right? Garbage. Garbage means random value. Anybody remembers? You can check the recordings on the YouTube. Okay, these are garbage values. So I have to solve this expression. The expression is that assignment minus plus plus. Which one has the highest precedence? Which one should I have to first? The assignment or minus or plus plus? Which one has the highest priority? Remember that we talk about all these in the arithmetic, logical, and relational operators. Parenthesis has the highest one. We already memorized this. And we talk that the unary operators, unary operators is the second. These are not, for example, anybody remember not? Negative, positive, plus plus, and minus minus. And then comes the arithmetic operators, then comes the relational operators, then comes the logical operators, and at the end we have the assignment operator. So I have to begin with plus plus. So plus plus D means what? Now D is 4. After that I have to do subtraction. So C value is 9. 9 minus 4 is here 5. And the A value will be not anymore garbage, but 5. Here you are gonna print the things here. So C value is 9. Pay attention, there is a space. We have to leave a space here. Okay. Then D value is 4. Okay. And then I have the A value, which is 5. So that is the answer for the, assume that you are in the exam, that's the correct answer. Okay. But what happens if I change these plus plus locations? What happens if I put here after the D, D plus plus? Do you think that the output will be the same? Do you think that the output will be the same? No. Why not? Let's do. I will use this color now. Again, I have, in this example, I have minus, plus, plus, and assignment. I have to begin with plus, plus. But D plus plus means what? D plus plus, bravo Mehmet Ali. D plus plus means that use the current value of D and then increment. The current value of D is 3. Remember that? 3. C value is 9. 9 minus 3 is 6. Now the A value is 6. After the calculation, I now made it 4. After the calculation. But A is already computed as 6. On the screen, what I am going to see? 9, 4, but 6. Eylül, is that clear for you now?
Yes, teacher.
But really, sincerely?
Yes.
Okay. So pay attention. In the exam, I will guarantee that after the exam, if you talk with your friends, everybody will be so sure that he or she finds the correct answer. Everybody will be sure. Because somebody find 9, 4, 5, somebody will find 9, 4, 6, and there will be a result for everybody. But there will be only single correct result. Okay. There is the second question. I left it for you as a homework. You do it at home. Here is the thing that I already remind you. You have to memorize it for your lifetime until you die. Okay, until you die. So you have to memorize all these things. The first thing is the parentheses. And the last thing is the, don't forget, assignment statement. So we have these new assignments. Okay, let me do it correctly. This assignment statement. In this time, we have this not only one assignment, but remember plus assignment, subtract assignment, multiplication assignment, division and modulus assignment. We have discussed. Then, in the second row, actually, we have the unary operations. Unary means takes only one operand, like negative or positive, or plus plus, or minus minus, or not. Remember not from the logical operators. After this comes the arithmetic operators. After the arithmetic operators, we have the relational operators. And after the relational operators, we have the logical operators. So you can memorize like that, okay? Otherwise, you cannot solve the expressions, or you cannot create the correct expressions, expected expression.